features, and they particularly often mention intonation. Now, I've got a very good message for you about intonation too. English intonation for Japanese speakers is very easy indeed. And the reason it's so easy, now you may not have thought it's easy, and you may even have been got an impression by reading something about it that it's very different. It isn't. Not if we're talking about a Japanese speaker having a conversation. If you, as a Japanese speaker using English, are having a conversation with another person speaking English, forget about intonation altogether. Just talk as comes natural to you, and you won't make any mistake in intonation. Now, that sounds a wonderful piece of news, but I've got to qualify it just one moment. You see, by intonation, I mean the narrow sense of the word intonation. Because intonation, unfortunately, is rather a vague word that some people use in one way and some in another. Now, most of us in the world of phonetics use it fairly accurately. What we mean by it is the melody in a speech, the rise and fall, the way the voice goes up and down as we speak. And that aspect of English, and that aspect of Japanese, have no very important and serious differences. So you can relax about it when you talk. What I have mentioned is that when you read aloud, and this is something that people learning to speak English as a foreign language forget, there is an enormous difference between talking to people, which is really what you want to do most, and reading aloud what somebody else has written. See, reading aloud what somebody else has written demands powers, training, abilities that are quite remarkably more difficult than just talking. Because what you are doing when you read aloud, not saying your own words spontaneously, but saying somebody else's words written by somebody else previously, is you're doing impersonation. And impersonation, pretending to be some other person, is often a very difficult thing to do. Some of us do it quite naturally, fairly well. A lot of us don't like to do it, or don't succeed very well. So don't worry too much. Unless you're a teacher of English, then you have to do a little of it. Don't worry, you don't have to worry about it at all, just to talk English. But it can be very difficult, and there are then rules about English intonation, about English melodies, that you have to try not to break. But on the whole, intonation is not a problem. Now, I go around the world saying this to people, and very often they haven't heard this said before. So I get raised eyebrows, if you know that. In other words, they look at me as much as to say, I've never heard that before, and that sounds a silly idea. But all right, my reaction to that is okay. But let me try and prove it to you by a practical demonstration. And the first thing is, I just said that intonation is not important, right? Certainly is important for a Japanese speaker speaking English spontaneously. One of the ways I can show you it's not important is that you will understand what I say if I don't use any intonation at all. And if I talk only on one pitch, and perhaps I stop doing that. Now I have started talking on only one pitch. What I am saying, I am sure, is perfectly understandable, just as clear as if I used various pitches. And now you might like to look at the paper of University College at the top. Can you see that paper? It says University College London with a pretty little picture of the dome above. And it says summer course in English phonetics. And now I'm going to read the first paragraph. Here it is. Even poor unfortunate monks and nuns in their holy monasteries and convents must surely get so terribly bored with singing on the hoop the whole time at just one single pitch level, that usually, if only at the very end of what they are singing, they make at least a very slight change of pitch. Right? So you see, you understood me all right. There wasn't any difference, but nobody wants to talk like that because it's so boring. it's a dull, right? Everybody naturally, instinctively shows you when they're more excited and hurrying on to say something, and when they've finished the bit they want to say, the little voice sink, right? It's a natural instinct.